Hi, this is Marcus. I'm going to create two analog film looks. I'm going to do one color and one black and white. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is get started. What I'm using right now is DxO Film Pack 5. It has over 80 analog film types built into it. And so what I do is I take the film types and I customize them to my likings. This is a model, I believe her name is Megan Randomski, I believe I'm pronouncing that correctly. This was at a workshop that I attended at MAP Studios. So this is a pretty nice photo of her right now. This is in color, but what I'm going to do is create some film looks for it. So we're going to go ahead and get started. The first thing I'm going to go ahead and do is, let me just give you an overview of the application. This right here is to save, to be able to save it to whatever I want to save it to. This right here is to save the preset, so I'll be using that. This is to compare. This right here allows me to do a snapshot, shows you the optimized view, but I haven't optimized anything, so I can get back to this point. So what happens is once I make edits, I can make a snapshot, so if something goes wrong, I can revert back to that snapshot. This right here will just give you a comparison of what you've done compared to the other one. This is to zoom in. This will give you one-to-one. So if I go ahead and hit this over here, which is going to give me the, if I go ahead and hit that, now if I move this to it, I mean, we have a one-to-one. You can see this is very close up on there. You can see the skin pixels and everything. This right here will zoom me back out. This is to be able to modify it, to be able to crop it, but you can see she's on the rules of thirds. I'm a stickler for that. So we can go ahead and take that off. That's to rotate it. This is to edit the film packs. This is to let me browse between different images and take me back to the browser. Of course, this is to hide the controls. So if I do that, now I can bring them back. This right here is for the navigator. Bring that back. And this is for the histogram. Bring that back. So what I'm getting ready to do right now, what you're looking at is all these presets of 154. That's because I've created a bunch of them. They only come with 80. Well, I think I have the Elite Pack, so it comes with 120. So I've created about 34 of them of my own. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start filtering. So I don't want to see any of my presets or any designer presets. All I want to see is right now black and white. I don't want to see the legacy. And all it's going to show me is black and white. So what I'm going to go down here and do is choose a black and white, and then I'm going to start editing from that. Now, I know the this doesn't show me the EXIF information on here of it being shot in 200 ISO. It was shot at the 200 ISO, and I believe it was shot at a aperture of 8.0, if I'm not mistaken. Probably a little higher, probably 11, because it's pretty sharp. So with that said, I'm only concerned with the ISO right now. So I can go 100 or I can go 200. If I go up, what it'll do is it'll create more noise. Like if I go ahead and hit this one right here, what it does is now when I go back into this one-to-one, you're going to see a lot of noise, and not noise, a lot of grain. And to the new photographers of the day, they would say this is very noisy, unusable photo. But if this was my goal, this would be fine. But what it does is this is showing me the delta 3200. It shows me when the film was first produced, who created it, what it was used for. It gives me some history on it, so I can have some idea of what it's being used for. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is we're going to go to probably, I'm not going to choose that one. Now I can edit this and keep it at that range. So let's say, for instance, if I wanted to do that, all I have to do is take the grain down, right? So I could actually, if this is, well, you know what? This is not bad. Let's go ahead and keep this. For the sake, I'm going to go ahead and build a preset out of this one. So the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and modify. So by modifying, what I'm doing is the intensity of this is fine. If I take the intensity of this, which in a Photoshop world would be opacity, if I took that down, it still doesn't affect the grain. Okay? So I'm just going to go ahead and do an undo. What we got to deal with here is the grain. Right? So the grain is a little bit too much for me, so I'm going to lower the grain down to about maybe 26. Let's go a little higher because I want some grain in there. Okay, let's go 31. Now to see how that actually looks, I'm going to go ahead and go in there. Okay, I can still see the detail of the skin. It's got some actual film grain in there, And this is one of the advantages that you have by using DxO. They've actually been able to put some science behind the software where they've been able to duplicate the film in a digital format, giving me actual grain of the film. So that's a real big plus, and especially if you're a stickler for wanting to actually, you know, replicate the film look. So that's going to work just fine at that grain. So now we're going to go ahead and hit develop. Now if I wanted to play with the exposures, I can. I think the exposure is fine. I don't need to do anything with the exposure. I like the little shadow areas that we have there. We're going to do some contrast. We are going to do some contrast, but I think I'm going to take the contrast in the reverse order, right, or lessen it. So it brings out a little bit more, you know, highlighting her hair. But then I'm going to go ahead here into the micro contrast and take it the opposite way. So it can really detail. Now you see her hair just really come out, but it's a little bit too sharp, so I don't want to do that. I'll take it to about 8, and then I'm going to go into the fine contrast, you know, and that's going to really pop those things out, like her eyes, and you can see the details of her lips. So that's going to be real good. Now we're looking at highlights. I don't want to touch the highlights. The histogram for highlights is already good, so we don't want to bother that. So, but I may touch the midtones. Let me just see how the midtones look if I raise them a little bit. Let's go to the extreme. You can see it's really bringing in harshness. And when you start changing the light, the key of when you're photographing a female is to always have soft light. What you don't want to do is start getting harsh light, because it starts to be just very unflattering to the model. So we don't want to do that at all. We want to take that back down. I'll maybe go to about 5 to bring in something. You can see the cleft in her chin. That's coming in. That's, you know, so that lets me be able to see that. And that's fine. So we're going to scroll down some more. Now we're going to the mixer. The mixer is going to actually, I'm going to take the histogram off because I don't need it on, so I can have more real estate. Now the mixer plays around with the DxO Film Pack 5.0 gives you the 256 shades of gray. But because this is a color photo being converted to a black and white, there are certain color spectrums that are sitting on that. Like, for instance, her face and maybe her lipstick will be on red. So if I took it to the extreme, you can see that that's affecting her face and her lips, and it's affecting a lot of stuff that's on that palette. So what I want to do is take that back, but I do want to lighten her up some. So maybe I take it to 14. That gives a little bit of light into that. Now, yellow is going to pretty much deal with any highlights that she has. Anything like highlights, or if there was anything in her hair. Again, if I take it to the extreme, you can see what it's doing with the hair. If I take it back to the other extreme, you can see it's really coming in. We're going to give it a mixture. I'm going to take it back down to maybe 11. Okay, we're going to leave it at that. There's really nothing on the green or blue spectrum that was on this. If I start moving those, it's not going to move anything. There may be something on the siren, but the magenta may have something on the lips. So let me take it to the extreme. Yeah, I don't see anything moving on that palette at all. So we're just going to leave that like it was. Now we're going to go with the tone curve. Now I can click on the red spectrum, the green, and the blue, but we're just going to do it overall. Now, one of the things that you do in Lightroom to give it a film look, if you didn't, wasn't using DxO, is when you start adding these points, right? You would actually take the point from here and move it up, and that would kind of mat it, which would give you a film look. I'm going to do that here. It may just a subtle change. I'm just so used to doing that. So if you're in Lightroom, you're trying to get the film look, especially in color or black and white, take that bottom point and bring that up, and you'll see that it gives a little film look. That's a little bit too much because I've got the film look within the software. So if I decide to bring that up right here, you can see how it distorts the side of her face. Don't want to touch that. There's really nothing for me to do with this at all. Actually, I'm just going to undo this because I don't have to do anything with it. But I just want to show you that's how you would do it in Lightroom to try to bring in some film look to it. We're going to go to the graphics. And the graphics give me frames. I don't need to put a frame on here. You know, if I want to add a frame, that's what it would give me. I don't need to do any of that. Textures, if I wanted to add some textures to this, let's say like a paper, let's say scratches. I want to add scratches to it, and then, again, lower the intensity of it, take it down to where I can have some scratches, and just start bringing it up where there was some in there. You know, you can see some going across to kind of give it some age as an older photo. But I'm not going to do that as well. So we're just going to take that back to zero. And so we're going to go ahead and... So now we're going to the light leak. If I wanted to use some light leak in here, I'll show you what I can do. You can add some color light leak. That would give you that. You could actually give it a grayscale light leak. You know, a white light leak. If I wanted to give it, you know, that type of look. Again, I'm not going for that right now, so I'm just going to go back up to the top. Say no light leak. Now we're into the filters. Now, if I was outside of something and wanted to use a filter and wanted to cool this off, I could go into warmer tones. If I do warm tones, you can see what it does with it. Kind of brings the highlights up. Doesn't do that much. If I went into the red, you're going to see what it really does to it. It really pops it out and it really, you know, kind of blows out the face. And you can do the same thing with orange, you know. But what I normally go to is the one that's for cool, right? And cool would kind of give it a darker look. And if I wanted that look to be in there, basically just lower the density of that. And you can see what it's doing just by lowering the density of it, right? But I don't need that to have that in there. So we're just going to say no filter, okay? No filter at all. And there's nothing really to, I can do a vignette. So I'm going to go ahead and bring some of the vignette in here, right? To where we got vignetting. I'm going to go ahead and put this point, which I will stick it on the point of her nose. Okay? And you know what? Maybe on her chin, because that'll bring in. And then we're going to do some transition. That shows me where it's coming from. So I want to be able to actually move that out, move it out a lot. Right? And around this, we can make it a rectangular. And I'm going to lower the density of it by right here. And go ahead and apply it. So we have some, but actually, if I'm going to do this as a preset, now I can use this as a preset, but when I bring another photo in, I'll have to remember if I use that preset to go ahead and change that point, because that point is set at her chin, but it may be a total different composition. So you know what? Actually, what I'm going to do with this is I'm not going to use any of this at all. Let's go ahead and do a reset, right? And we're going to go ahead and just pull these back to zero, back to where they were. Let's not do anything with them. Let's do again. Let's take them back. There's no reason to use it. You can see it goes back to what it's supposed to be. We're going to do that, okay, because there's no reason to do that. And, of course, I don't need to blur anything back because there's nothing to blur out. So with that done, if this is sufficing, I think it is, I'm going to go ahead and save this preset. We're going to go ahead and hit apply. And then it's going to go ahead and hit this and say save this. And I'm going to say LDS Delta 3200. So, Delta 3200, I'm going to say this preset is based on the Delta 3200 black and white film to be used on close-ups and portraits. And that information comes in handy about a month from now when I say, oh, what did I create it for? And I'm going to go ahead and save this. Now, one of the cool things about this as well is that I'm able to go under here if I wanted to, and I can actually export all of my custom presets and share them with individuals, which I don't. That's one thing I don't share. I don't share off the certain looks I have. That's part of my digital darkroom. I don't do that, but I have the ability to do that. So anyway, so that one's done. So that would be the black and white look that I would want. And I could actually push that out, and it looks good. So now we're going to go back to this tool I told you. So if we go and do a compare, let's close this. You can see this is what I started with. This is what I ended up with, which is fine, right? So now I'm going to just go ahead and do this. And I could go ahead and play around with this and slide it back and forth, and you can see the difference in where the stuff is at. But we're going to go ahead and do this. Now what I'm going to go and do is go back to my original recalled image. So that's how it was when I started. Now we're going to do some color. So let's go ahead and get this off right now. We're going to go into the filter. I'm going to do color. I'm going to do legacy films. None of my presets to show up. Okay. So now that we got that going, what I want to do right now, and it's basically trying to add a film type onto this. Okay. It looks like it's got film on there already, but I can do a little bit better. Let's go with the Polaroid 669. Okay, that's the Polaroid look 669 for the film. And if you look at the history of it, it was first produced in the 1960s, and the production was 2008. Tells you who created it, why it was used, gives you some scenarios of the sensitivity for ISO. I shot this at 200. It was normally for 80 or to 100, but I'm going to use it because it's going to do very well. And the grain on this is not going to be unpleasing even at 100%. So if I zoom in, you can see the grain is still acceptable on this photo without any issues. The grain is going to be fine. So I'm going to zoom out of this. That's fine. I'm going to go ahead and close this. But now we're going to do some modifications. That's right. We're going to go ahead and modify. So one thing that I'm going to go ahead in here and do is I'm looking at the density for this, and that's fine. What I want to do is I want to take some of this saturation down. I'm going to reverse it, okay? Actually soften it up a little bit. That's what I'm going to do with that. And the vibrance, her lips is fine. If I took that down, you'll see what it actually does. It just kind of makes it kind of flat. I'm going to go in the reverse area. So now she's got kind of a little highlight here from the light, but this is the look I want to go for, right? So now contrasting. She's got a lot of contrast right now. If I take that back, you can see that it's going to lighten it up. So I want to lighten it up a little bit. And again, the trick I'm going to do is I'm going to go with the micro contrast, and that's going to really bring out portions of her hair, right? It's going to really bring out those portions. And then this time, I'm going to go in the reverse order for the micro, for the fine contrast. And then the highlight, I do want to bring that down because that highlight is actually showing. So if I go and look at the histogram of it, I have the highlight down right now. She's got some hot spots in the face. That's because of the lighting, but we're going to leave that there because the overall look of this is pretty good. I'm not necessarily correcting the photo. What I'm doing is building a look, and I really like this look the way it is. So the contrast is fine. I could go with the mid-tones if I wanted to and bring the mid-tones down. You can see if I go to the extreme, you can see what it does. It kind of flattens it out. If I go up in here, you can look at that. Now, that's not her skin, but you can see why you don't want to deal with harsh light. So we're going to take it back about 12. If I go back here, that'll work fine. And shadows, you can take the shadows back. I can increase the shadows. You can really see her hair coming out, but that makes it too harsh. That's not the look I'm going for, but you know something? I like how that hair came out. So we're going to do that. So it really brings out the blackness and those things like that. So we're going to leave it like that. And really for this, I'm not going to do too much to that. Now, there is going to be a tonal curve that I'm going to do here. I'm going to hit this, and I'm going to do this. I'm going to bend this down here, and I'm going to go back up to here. Let's take the histogram off so I got more room. And I'm going to go ahead and drag this up like this. That'll lighten it up. That's going to work for me right there. And I'm not going to use any frame. I'm not going to use any textures. You know what? I may use some texture this time because I'm trying to create this color different look. What I would be adding stains and scratches. Let's see some. If I added this stain here, what would it do? I can do that if I want to make it look like an antique look, but I don't want to do that because there's different ways that I can randomize it, but I don't want to do that at all. Let's just take that off. Okay. We're going to go back into the lighting effect of this. I'm not going to add any light leak. There's nothing. I am going to add some kind of vignetting, but a very small amount of vignetting right there. Nothing really out of the way. And I'm going to leave it to where it's centered, to where it is, and that's fine. So I'm going to go ahead and hit apply. And pretty much that's the look that I got. So if I go back and compare, right, if I hit this and compare, you can see what I started with and now what I have right now. And you know what? I'm going to go into one thing. I'm going to do this. While I got them both open, I want to cool it off. So let's go into, so we got the filters. Let's go into the lens filter. Let's do a cool tone. And that gives me a real cool tone. So that's one I want to be able to keep with that. And I'm going to lower the density of that. So some of that warmness come in. That's the look I want to have for that. That's the film look for that one. So again, I forgot which film I used. I'm just so used to doing this, so let's do this again. So let's go to the top, no problem. I'll go to the top and see the Polaroid 669. So I'm gonna go ahead and save this one and call it LDS, Fuller Shaw Digital Studio, Polaroid 669. And again, this is not correcting the photo, this is creating the look that I'll probably use on other photos. And so I'll say this preset is based on the Polaroid 669 to be used with portraits. And close-ups. And I'll go ahead and save this. And that's my look. So if I go back and look at the filters that I've done, that I've brought over, if I just do this and say we're going to filters, I'm going to look at both black and white, and I'm going to take off everybody's stuff except for my presets. You can see all the ones that I've created, right? And I have a whole bunch of them that I've actually created. And so if I was just going to go in to do different ones, if I went into this one right here, this may not fit that one. That brings it too dark. She looks almost like a Latina or African-American woman. But I have different looks for different things, and they don't fit every photo. They're actually for different things out here. Street photography, luscious black and white. If I click on this one here, you'll see how it's changing with the filters and stuff. And so that's how that's done. I'm going to go back to this. I'm going to go ahead and kill these filters. Let's get all the filters off. Take my presets off. Let's put the ones back on here. And that's how it works. So I just want to share that with you. So thanks for watching.